Are you an entrepreneur that wants to level up, be more productive, be more creative, create more impact and income in the upcoming year or whenever you're watching this? If that is the case, there is one main thing that's gonna help you get there, and that's having the right rituals and habits that are gonna help you consistently succeed. That's why in this video, we're gonna talk about the top five habits that every entrepreneur has to implement right now to grow their business, coming up. If you're new here, my name is Christopher Dedan. Welcome to my channel, the one-stop shop for peak performance, entrepreneurship, and personal growth. So the first habit to implement is reading more. So if you guys know who I am or you checked out my YouTube channel, you know that I am a fan of reading. So much so that I actually have a book reviewing series on my channel, which I'll link up right now. As an entrepreneur, the more you read, the more it's gonna give you a competitive edge towards everybody else. That is just the honest truth. Now, there's some people that may assume, oh, you know what? I'm starting a business or I'm doing this, I'm doing that. I don't have time to read because it's not a money-making activity. But that is not right at all. That is incorrect because the reality of the matter is the more you read, the more you earn. It's just directly correlated. So there's such a great way to accumulate knowledge that you don't probably have, to accumulate new techniques to learn something about it, is through reading. Because the reality is, how do you have access to these amazing people, to these investors, these people that already done it, to whoever that you idolize other than their book? And within their book, they're literally putting down all of their years of experience in like 300 pages, 200 pages, whatever the length of the book is. So it's extremely important and almost mandatory. If you want to succeed, you have to add reading to your schedule. Now here's the thing that's cool about this. You don't have to read hours and hours. All you have to do is 10 minutes per day or 20 minutes per day. If you consistently do that, and listen to the word consistent here, it's gonna come out often within this video. If you're consistent on that, at the end of the day, at the end of the year, you're gonna have consumed a lot of information through books. The second habit to implement is control your calendar and agenda. Now this is extremely important, and it's actually very surprising to me. As I started my coaching career, I realized how many entrepreneurs that are even succeeding very well don't have this structured. What you want to do is have an electronic agenda such as Google Calendars, and the second there's something that comes up, a meeting that comes up, right away you put it in your agenda. Because what that does is it diminishes the cognitive pressure for you to remember things. You're not supposed to try to remember, I have to call X, Y, and Z person, or I have a meeting here or that and the other. Because as you're going to become more and more successful, I'm telling you, your agenda and your weeks are going to get filled weeks in advance. So how are you going to remember what you need to do in 2 weeks if it's not written down? So the best way to go about it is structured and put it in your agenda right away. Because what happens is that as an entrepreneur, your agenda is gonna be your lifeline. And not only for your business, but for your personal life as well. You're gonna put things in there to really know what you need to do. As you do that at such a high level, what's gonna happen is you're gonna become more productive, you're gonna create more time within your day, and you're just gonna be more structured. So get your agenda in order and fix that right away. If you see there's some value within this video so far, don't hit that at all to give me a like, hit that subscribe button, and turn on the bell notification to find out when our weekly videos come out. So the third habit to implement is drink more water. Now this is not only important for entrepreneurs, but it's important for everybody. Research has proven this. The more hydrated you are, the more effective you're going to be within your work. So you do not want to be dehydrated. Now the best way to go about it is you always want to have a bottle of water at arm's reach. Now, the best way to find out what's the quantity of water you should drink, what I found out is you take your body weight in pounds, divide that in half, and it's gonna give you a number which is the quantity that you should be drinking in ounces. So let's clarify that. I weigh 150, cut that in half, 75. That's how much I should be drinking in ounces, which is approximately 2.2 liters. So 2.2 liters for me is probably this bottle four times, give or take. So the only disadvantage, to be quite honest, of drinking so much water is that you have to have access to a washroom. But other than that, you're gonna be so much more productive, you're gonna be so much more creative, and you're gonna have more energy to finish off your day and be so much more effective. The fourth habit to implement is revenue versus profits. Now, I see a lot of young entrepreneurs make this mistake. They chase that amount, they chase that dollar figure. Like imagine we say it's $1 million. But there's a difference between $1 million revenue and $1 million profit. For me, $1 million profit is so much more interesting, because if it took you 1.1 million to make $1 million in revenue, then you're not ahead of the game. So you have to be acutely aware as an entrepreneur, what is going into your business and what is coming out of your business? Where is that money figure going in and out? One tool to do so and to really have a great understanding of that is a tool called QuickBooks. This is going to help you out to really figure out how much is going out to payments, how much is going into investment, what is costing this, what is costing that. As you're aware of your financial figures, you're gonna be able to succeed at such a high level. Now, one example that I like over here, a rule, actually, that was put together by Grant Cardone, he talks about in his book 10X, which I've done a book review, I'll link it up, is the 40-40-20 rule, which means 40% of your salary or your income is going to be put away for taxes, another 40% should be invested, and 20% is the amount you should be living on. So if you keep that rule some way, shape, or form, 40% taxes, 40% investing, and 20% of what you should be living on, then you have a good idea of where you should be investing your money and not spending it aimlessly. The fifth habit to implement is consistent auto-evaluation. Now, as an entrepreneur, if you're not able to track and measure your progression, you're not gonna succeed. You have to look at what you're doing good and look at things that might be needing of some improvements. Now, to do so, you have to put systems in place to always track that. Just like we just spoke about previously, finance is one, but your personal development is another, and your business growth is another as well. You could be putting performance reviews with some of your employees as well. Now, one trick that I like to use is business journals. You could fill out your goals for your quarter coming up. You could fill out your weekly goals, your daily goals, and then every single time you evaluate. How did my day go? What did I learn? What could I have improved on? Do the same thing with your week and with your quarters. As you keep this tracking of your progression, you're gonna succeed at such a high level because you're gonna be looking at yourself in the mirror and keeping yourself accountable. The name of the game is accountability and massive clarity. The only way you're gonna get it is through auto-evaluations. I hope you enjoyed the video and you got some great ideas and some habits and rituals that you can implement that's going to help you out to grow your business to the next level. And the question of the day, which is more like of an accountability of the day for this video, is which of these habits are you committed to implementing right now in your life? Comment down below. I would love to see what the community is going to say on that end. Furthermore, it's going to keep you accountable to respecting it and developing this new habit. Now, there's some other videos over here that could interest you. The first one is on my entrepreneurship series. Over here, you have my peak performance mindset series. Over here, you have my book review series and you have my profile picture. You guys can click, subscribe, and join the family. I hope you guys have a blessed and grateful day.